Now we will learn how to draw the orthographic views of a given pictorial view. A pictorial view is given, of which we have to draw three views. A front view looking in the direction of arrow. Right hand side view. And last is a top view. Use a first angle method of projection to draw its three views. Observe the given component carefully. Try to read dimensions of each and every line which is shown in the 3D pictorial view. Looking in the direction of arrow, we have to draw its front view. Try to build up judgment. The visible and hidden surfaces which will be observed while we are considering direction of arrow to draw its front view. Visible and hidden surfaces are shown here. The three hidden surfaces will be observed. Rectangular slot and semicircular hole will be observed. Now for top view, when we are looking in top side, then these three red color surfaces will be observed in top view, whereas the rectangular slot cut at the bottom side will be appear as a hidden. Now for right hand side view, these green colored three surfaces are clearly visible, whereas the rectangular slot cut to the rear side will not visible, so we have to show it by using dotted line. Then trace out the overall dimensions. Overall length is 60, height is 50 millimeter, and width is also 50 millimeter. Now prepare three frames. This is the first frame for front view, in which we are preparing rectangle of which length is 60 millimeter and height is 50 millimeter. Now we are preparing frame for top view of which the length is 60 millimeter and width is 50 millimeter. Now prepare the frame for right hand side view of which the dimensions are length is 50 and height is 50 millimeter. These three frames for three views should be placed at a 20 millimeter distance apart, means these three frames have located 20 millimeter away from each other. Now try to draw front view. Now in front view, this yellow color surface which is of a geometrically L shape is clearly visible. Try to trace out all the dimensions and draw its front view by visible outline. Now we have to draw the hidden surface, that is a rectangular slot, which is located at a 10 millimeter distance from left side, represented by a dotted line. The depth of this dotted line will be of only 40 millimeter. Then we have to show semicircular drilled cut portion by using dotted lines. Take its dimension and show it by dotted line. Now we have to show the rectangular slot which is cut at the bottom side by using dotted line. Take its respective dimension, that is a position of this dotted line from bottom line, and draw its hidden portion in front view. Now we have to draw top view. Now in top view, three surfaces are visible of a red color. So to draw this, take the projections of a vertical lines from top view. All these projections should be extended in top view. Now consider the top surface of a red color, which appears approximately H geometrical shape, which is of a H geometrical shape. Now locate the slot width by taking its respective dimensions. And complete. Now locate the center point or semicircle. Take the respective dimension in compass and draw the semicircle. And complete the top view. Now complete the third visible portion, which is observed in top view. Now to draw side view, take the projections from front view. Project horizontal lines. Now here we have to draw the hidden portion, which is not visible in top view, by dotted lines. Means we are drawing the bottom slot cut by dotted lines. Now for side view, we are taking the horizontal projections from front view, as well as take the vertical projections by using the compass with the from top view. Now draw a shape which is visible in side view by using the H grade pencil. Now to draw side view of a semicircle, take the projection of a center line from top view and show the center line in side view. Complete the semicircular portion, which appears as a rectangle. Thus all visible surfaces are shown in side view. Now we have to draw the hidden portion. So take the projection of a slot from top view, marking the projections point in side view, draw a dotted vertical lines which will indicate the hidden portion which is not visible in right hand side view. Now give dimensions. While giving the dimensions, follow the align dimension of 16. We are drawing a horizontal dimension lines, and dimension is placed above that dimension lines. Be careful that when we are representing the horizontal dimensions, all dimensions must be placed above dimension line. Here we are showing the dimensions of a vertical line. Now where we are drawing vertical dimensions, the dimension should be placed at a middle position, and it always placed to the left side of a dimension line, so that we can read it from right side. Never give the dimensions with the reference of a dotted line. Here we are giving the dimensions of a bottom cut slot of a height 10 millimeter. Here we are giving the same dimension of a slot in top view, which is of a 10 millimeter. The width of that slot in top view, which is of a 20 millimeter. Try to distribute the dimensions in all these three views. Give the dimensions of a circle, draw this leader line which passes through the center point of a circle, and note about this dimension, that is radius 15. This is the height of a semicircular hole, semicircular cut portion. Thus, in this way, the figure is completed. Follow this instruction, that is, draw the construction line and the projection lines by using the 2H grade pencil. Visible outline by H grade, give necessary dimension and follow the align dimension system.